afternoon.
Hi. I'm Sridhar, working for Capillary Technologies. I'm expertised in integrating business analytics, statistics with the technology to empower the business managers. Today's session will be more focused on how your favorite retailers make money out of the analytics. Now, this is a dicey question where is it the technology helping the business to improve, or is it a statistics, or is it the analytics? Yeah, my answer would be like it's a combination of all the three which is making the business more prominent and more technical. Since yesterday we have been having a sessions on banking, finance, media, and this is more concentrated on retail business, where day to day we go to your shopping, we have a food and grocery, we buy apparels, we go to a restaurant, we order a pizza. So all this comes under retail analytics. Here we are going to focus on the retail analytics area, where the whole outcome of this presentation would be takeaways, three insights, possible three things which can go out of this room and just implement it as immediately as possible and improve the favorite retailer's business. So this do include the techniques, what has been implemented and how that needs to be implemented, how that needs to be executed, and what is the impact due to implications of these techniques. So the biggest breakthrough in this new era of retail analytics is integration between a business person with a statistics and a technology. I'm not sure how many of the technicians, tech geeks are here, and analytics geeks are here, or business managers here. Can I have some hand raises for tech geeks? Oh great. Statisticians? Oh very few. So this session is for a whole set of audience where it will be concentrating on both of them. The first breakthrough, which is like, is a real-time engagement model. Have you ever imagined you stepped into your store, the store staff, the retailer has received you very well with a name, with a purchase what you have done. What is the impact of it? He take a feedback of the products, he take a feedback of the suit you have bought in the previous purchase, and then he recommends what is the best product for you. Yeah, seems surprisingly very easy with the unorganized stage. All when we go to our tier 2 cities or the villages, the retailer know the name, what we do, what we like, do we like suit. He's up to date on all the information. Can we implement the same kind of a thing on a bigger retailers like a Big Bazaar or a Shopper Stop or a Lifestyle, where the store staff is more interactive with the consumer with the real-time technology? So this real-time technology has been improved the retailer sales by 4%. Then we'll going in the further slides, we'll understand how that 4% has been increased using this technology. Now the second part is, we know there's a social media, the data is coming from social media, there is coming from e-commerce, the data is coming from online. Lots of data, tons of data. Does it make sense if we integrate the whole things? Now, how it can be helpful? As we heard in the yesterday's few of the sessions also, that your credit, if you are making a transaction in your credit card above a 1 lakh or 2 lakhs, there's an immediate call comes to you saying that, sir, has the purchase has been done by you or is it a fraud? Yeah, banking industry is very much mature enough to have this technology in place, but the retail is very new. It's very new due to two reasons. One, kind of a data which was captured in the past. Now, due to the technology improvement in the current decade, we have started capturing the data. How that can be helpful? As simple as that. If a customer stepped into your store, has given you a mobile number and email ID, and he logged into your Facebook after a day, where he has actually allowed the credentials to share with the, let's say, bank like Puma, or a jewelry like Gitanjali. So he shares the information with the Gitanjali, and after the 10 days after that, he changed his marital status to an engaged. How do you feel if someone calls you up, he interlinked your email ID, he interlinked your mobile number, someone called you up, sir, it's good to have that your engagement has been fixed, can you have some shopping at a jewelry shopping at Gitanjali store? Yeah. So there the quality information is there. There the events has been transacted, the consequences of this event can be tracked very easily. So here we will be talking about some integration between all these techniques. Where we have been talking about personalization, customization. This is on the basis where customer is an individual, not a group event. We'll go further into this customer as an individual, how the Bayesian prediction models and linear regression models has helped retailers increasing the sales. Now, to give a brief introduction of the retail industry, retail accounts to 15% of the Indian GDP, which accounts to 470 billion. And there are 11 shops out of 1,000 people. But of course, having said that it is 470 billion GDP, there is only hardly 3 to 4% as an organized sales. Now today, as on today, the data which we are capturing of the whole population in India is only 3%. Now how as the organization sales keeps on improving, the kind of a data we'll be capturing will be very higher. 60% comes from verticals other than food and grocery. True. So always the analytics is more concentrated in food and grocery. How we can implement to the how we can implement that to a pizza business? How we can implement that to an apparel business? How we can implement that to a footwear sales and a spa and salon? It's very important. The analytics can be helpful everywhere. Yeah. So what is the challenges in retail industry? One is it really the data hygiene is the issue or the lack of it? I mean, how many of you feel that data hygiene is the issue in the retail industry? Okay, lack of it. So we have seen that there is a 6,000 TB of data has been captured in the year of 2011. Compared to an internet data, hardly it seems like an internet data which has been captured in a day. But it's much very valuable information where the complexity calculations and complexity predictions will matter in the retail industry, where we are going to focus today. Now, connecting the customer online, offline, and social media is very important because the same individual has been making the transactions across. The other big is the playing with the scale of data. Now, coming to an example like a grocery industry where there are thousands of products. It's very difficult to understand which product is moving with which product. Always we do in a categorical manner which category is moving with other category. But is there a scope of improving the business through the retail data? Yes, there is a huge scope of it. Now, why in such a limited tools to analyze data is more tools have been developed by the big MNCs for banking industry, but there are very few less tools for the retail industry. Yeah. So what are the typical business problems in a retail? Typical business problems in a retail are hardly have a campaign conversion up to 2 to 3%. There's a campaign, there's a promotion which is executed in the retail industry, hardly 2 to 3%. But really speaking, a banking industry have a higher scope of conversion rate just because the fact that there is less competition, there is less churn rate, the customer going away is very less because he stick to the brand. If he changes to other bank, he need to change his loan account, he need to change his investments, he need to change a hell lot of things. Whereas I buy a footwear in a Woodland and tomorrow itself I can go and buy a footwear in a Puma. Whereas in Indian industry, that's a problem in the Indian industry. No person is more loyal towards any brand. Are any people is agreeing with me that no person is brand to any particular brand? Yeah. So it's loyalty. Loyalty comes into the picture. Where Indian people are more relaxed and will be keep on shopping across the brands. So that was the biggest problem. Now, how we can tackle that problem? Can we do something when the customer is in the store, when he's already purchasing, can we do some in-store engagement activity? How that can be achieved through analytics? How that can be achieved through technology? Can cover it in the next couple of slides. The second problem is high communication cost and less relevance. Yeah, we have seen in the most of the developed countries, the communication cost is up to $1 for the direct mailers, and even the text cost and the EDM cost is very higher. Yeah, we have heard about a propensity model can give a lift up to two times, three times of the lift. Yeah, so the propensity model is built based on one objective, saying that how many set of customers can respond to a beauty products campaign? How many set of customers can respond to a EDM? How many set of customers can respond to a home appliances campaign? Now, as we keep on counting, there will be a hell lot of products, and there will be a hell lot of propensity models which needs to build. Yeah. Can we build something which can cover whole set of marketing initiatives? Yeah. So in our experience, we have built 15 propensity models. We'll go in detail afterwards. But yeah, we have built 15 propensity models to tackle the marketing initiatives for the whole 1 year. It's not an ad hoc, but it's a whole 1 year we have made a prediction models to make sure how they are coming in the future. The third problem is the customer drop rate, 80 to 85%. It's like huge. Hardly 15% of the customers are your loyal customers. Where are the remaining customers are going on? Yeah. So, need to engage each customer uniquely by understanding the customer in a better manner. So, those are few of the prediction algorithms we have categorized. Yeah. So, we all know marketing. So, simple the kinds of marketing and the kind of analytics we do right now. The kind of analytics what we do right now is we define a marketing activity which needs to be planned in our next couple of years, so next couple of months. What that marketing activity should be? What do? We do logistics, we do predictions, we do discriminant models, we do Bayesian models to predict when the customer is going to come, what the customer is going to purchase. The other is the after marketing activity, where we understand the kind of hypothesis what we've considered in the before marketing activity is valid or not. Use text minings to find out to concise the feedback analysis, to concise the customer complaints. Have you ever thought about during in-store activity, which is the execution has happened, the plan of the execution has done, okay? In between the execution and before execution, after execution, there's one more level of technology came into picture due to the cloud-based solutions, due to the real-time technologies, which is the during in-store activity. We will engage when the customer is in the store. So that's a real-time, power of the real-time results. How does it work? Simple. Now, taking an example as a grocery store, we went to purchase in a grocery store and we purchased a basket of goods. Analyze the basket of goods. What exactly is present in the basket, what exactly is not present. That feeds into your recommendation engine, where the current recommendation engine, the typical traditional way of cross-selling is, we compare what product is going with what, as simple as that, which is, we are currently covering what really goes with what, to marry it with the business objective. Yeah. There are two other points which is getting missed out, is what the customer is missing in the basket. That's something the customer needs and it is getting missed out in the basket. One. Two, have you ever thought about, does this customer need it? Or is it a push from the marketing? So that's two major points which actually drive the business to the next level. So here, with the four factors, which is what is missing in the basket, what really goes with what, customer path, past purchase data, and business objective. So all this happens in a store where the billing happens. So in the meanwhile, the scanning of the pause is happening. Scanning of the whole items is happening. Whole this real-time algorithms works out. What the customer needs. So the system throws out with the instant suggestions, and it shows off what is a real-time execution, how that needs to be executed. That end up in a business impact, which is the retailer is making money. So, how it flows? This customer stepped into a store, he purchased, yeah? So, after his purchase, we understood what he needs, we understood what he is missing in the basket, and then we value the patronage of the customer, and we offer you something at the store. So, where the conversion rates can go up to 5 times or 6 times. Really, that makes wow to the customer. But how it works? So, this is more on the statistics way and more on the approach how we have tackled. But let me tell you in a very simple way. So, we have considered the products in a grocery store. What are all the products available in the grocery store? Take it just grocery. What is the percentage that B will be going with A if A is present in the basket? Yeah, as simple as that. As all the statisticians love to work on the two levels of layer. Now the complexity comes in where I want to define for layer 3, for layer 4, layer 5 to understand what exactly is there in the basket. Yeah. So this is more on the using the base probability. But the same kind of a thing can be done using the appropriate algorithm. But there are the pros and cons of both algorithms are much different. Here in this context, we are using a Bayesian probability to understand what is the probability of C buying C if the A and B are already in the basket. What is that probability? Which is with the past history of the customer and past history of the other customers, we can get to know what is the probability of A, B, C together by probability of A multiplied by probability of B saying that A is already in the basket. Yeah. So this can be extended to the N layers, which we call it as a N layer basket, where it will be keep on moving. If the customer purchases today, he purchased A and B and D. So immediately the A flows A to B, B to D, and then the layer 4 comes into picture. What A, B, D and what else can go with the customer's interest? Yeah, so all our information, we have one of our product where all the information of the customer is storing in at the store.
So how does they update us then? This is
the new customer view,
right?
This is not customer view, this is a customer current basket.
Current basket, right?
Yeah.
So you have some previous knowledge about
I'll come to that. Yeah. So this is currently analyzing the data which is currently present in the basket, current basket. Now, what can be done? So, after this, the second step of the algorithm is where it will check. Now we have studied about the missing basket. Now the second step would be what customer needs it. Is it really the product E is needed by the customer? Is a need for the customer? When the product E has been purchased, how many days back? Whether it has purchased 10 days back or 20 days back? If it is a 10 kg of atta which is purchased 10 days back, there is no point in giving initiative on the atta again right now. Yeah. So what will happen is it will learn about the past history, when that particular last product has been bought. Okay, is it the real need of the customer or not? Yeah, that is the second step of it. Now, so we can build up to as many rules as possible, and at the end of a bill or end of a slip you get as a bill, that the whole missing baskets can be printed out of it saying that these could be the possible missing baskets in your bill.
So the kind of rules that are set, like for example, if somebody has bought the atta 2 days back, it will be needing to come. These are like hand-coded rules or?
No. That's a system rules which has been taken care of.
So how do you infer those kind of rules?
So once, should I answer it right now or at the end of the session?
We can actually take the questions once the...
Yeah, once it is done, I will take that question. Yeah, so there is a selection rule and a rejection rule. Which we are talking about, the past purchaser behavior is very important. Very important in terms of rejecting something or selecting something. And all this happens on a click when the scanning is happening. Yeah. So Now we have studied about how we can through the real time technology we can increase the conversion rates up to 2 to 3%. We have seen in the studies that it has actually went up to 20% and raised the customers retailer business by 4%. Now coming to the interesting part would be sorry, I have actually there's a flow problem. So this we have studied about the grocery store. How we can change the things in a departmental store right now? The departmental store have a different set of different varied categories, menswear, women's wear, and home appliances, electronics. So it has different set of products in a one departmental store. So can we do something for which can suitable to the whole marketing for whole 1 year, not just for one of the month or one of the day or one of the week? So there comes big and complex data along with the marketing offers. So more or less the marketing has been in a saturation state for the last 50, 100 years. Everyone know what actually needs to be executed. Everyone know what needs to be done and what should not be done. So taking those into consideration, can we mingle? Can we merge with that with the big and complex data? So how that can be done? We have approached in a different manner where we have built a 15 propensity models based on the 15 marketing different offers. Yeah. So typical propensity model will give a result of we will make sure we are targeting only 20 to 30% of the customers. But this kind of approach will make sure one customer will get two or three offers at least and the best offers, best marketing offers to them. So 15 predictive propensity models has been built based on the 15 marketing initiatives using logistic and discriminant. And then the primary challenge in terms of statistics is merging all those 15 propensity models into one and assigning the best one offer one, offer two, offer three against each customer. And that has been tagged for the whole 1 year and it can be executed at any point of time without any lag in the execution. So after applying this, we can do a design of experiments. How this impact can happen? Where the random way of doing a propensity model with one propensity model actually can give a lift up to only 2 to 3 times. But by actually multiplying this up to 15 propensity models and make sure all the customers, sets of customers comes in the picture, can give up to 20% conversion, where the profit would have been multiplied by 25 times. So now, interestingly, departmental store we have studied, and now coming into pizza business, how that works. Then we all like a pizza and love to have an order every alternate week or every week. Yeah. So the pizza loyalty program is more than a driven by a group rather than an individual. Where the customer loyalty program needs to be changed into a family loyalty program. Then internally, what we have done was to tagging the customers. So instead of treating as a customer, we treat as in a family. The whole set of four people belong to one family. Yeah. How this can impact the business is when I'm doing a direct mailer, I don't know the customer 1 and customer 11 are same. But while using this all these regex algorithms and phenotic and edit distance, we have merged the customers. The whole merging has actually merged 20% of the customers, which actually decreased the marketing cost by 20% simply. Without any impact, without any changes, it has actually decreased the 20% marketing cost. Now, coming to this pizza business, who is your customer? So typically, we do a clustering or segmentation and say, there's my high loyal customers, there are my high spender customers, there are my discount seekers, there are my potential customers. Can we do something more than that? Are we missing something? Do you like to have a chicken tikka pizza every time, right? So this is not actually taking care of the segmentation here. Is not taking care of any chicken tikka pizza or your favorite pizza or your garlic bread or your pasta. What you have done is you took a taste clustering also into picture, which is saying you tend to have a same pizza every time, or you tend to have a three different pizzas alternatively. How you change your pizza preferences comes in the y-axis dimension. And then further we have drilled down into 17,000 segments using the taking the significant variables from chi-square model, chi-square test, yeah, with seven dimensions. Now, interestingly, in PISA, we have understood that the stickiness of the PISA is up to 60%. The same person ordering on a Saturday evening last week, and he tends to order the Saturday evening again, is 60%. So that's a very brief insight which actually made us to make a high level of segments where the customer will be treated as a unique individual rather than a group. Yeah. So how it works in a week? So how it works? So customer made it first purchase, second purchase, and third purchase. Now after this last purchase, when is the next order? Can we predict that? Yeah. Using the number of customer visits, the last purchase, micro segment where he belongs to, customer frequency using linear regression models, yeah, all this actually tend to make a continuous engagement with the 17K. So this is actually avoiding a marketing person to get away saying that there is a dip in the sales, do the campaign today. Yeah. Don't. It's a different way of approach where we see that the customer is customer. Customer is actually a customer, not a job businessman. Yeah, he actually adds a value to it. So make customer engagement plan rather than pushing your something to the customer. So this linear regression technique actually takes care of external events like cricket and football matches also. So how we can grow the retailer's business? So if we have no data, decades back, 20 years back, we don't have any data in the retail, where we say we acquire the customer, engage the customer, retain the customer, and grow the customer. How the lifetime value used to be increased is like negligible. So what happens if non-analytics data-driven marketing happens, where there are lots of bulk things which is happening to you, bombarded to you without any analytics? So it can grow up to a certain while, and after that it can drop off. But whereas if you are doing with an analytics way, it is going to help your business and retain your business for quite a long time. So here we have a very good examples where all customers are treated similarly. $1 investment has given a $1.8 of ROI return, and when the customer has treated separately with a 17K segments, $1 investment has given a $9 simply by introducing a linear regression technique to understand, predict when he is going to order a pizza, made an improvement like $1 investment has given another $20. So this is a real case study how we have grown the business to the retailer in the past. Thank you. Any questions?
This one? One of the problems.
So regex is a regular expression. It compares the strings, so it can extract the house numbers, it can extract landmarks for you based using the regex expression. So this is more on the statistics side and the technological side where regular expressions can be used. Yeah.
Is integrating with the fragmented PO system, especially in areas that are mainly in India. So how do you guys handle that?
So we are majorly in India, where we have integrated with most of the POS systems, because of which the whole online data and the offline data and the social media data can be integrated across the whole one platform. So that is actually helping in making this real-time engagement plan very well.
So you guys have budget behavior of a user across retailers.
Yes,
are you,
yes.
Are you guys doing the cross promotion?
No. We do for one of the business at a time.
Only one at a time.
Yeah.
Just wanted to ask, are you specifically picked up examples like pizza and retail outlets and proper safe kind of thing? How do you relate real time in case of websites, like online shopping websites?
Yeah, so real time is very easy.
So, I mean, what my question is primarily, in this case you are associating in a customer who has done a point of purchase and point of sale, when you can buy a product from there. So, when you actually associate this with the online shopping per se, how do you associate the end user attributes?
So the end user attributes can be captured or can be registered in the store, can be registered in the e-commerce website, can be registered in the social media. Wherever it could be, the registration can happen in one shot.
Sorry to interrupt. The question is about real time. Like if I am browsing through my PC or desktop, I'm doing some surfing, I'm doing some activity of purchase and stuff like that. And if I'm doing from a mobile or an iPad or something like that, the devices are different. So tracking activity is different, user behavior is identified separately.
Yeah.
How do you associate the end user who may not be logged in with just adding it to the basket?
Okay.
How do you associate his past history into different devices and make real time associations?
So currently the real-time association, what I'm talking about is the store.
Yeah, so this is only about point of sale.
Yeah, point of sale. Because the point of sale is a very difficult part because the integration comes into picture with the different processes. Yeah. Should I? Rohani? Yeah.
You said by grouping 20% of the customers by identifying potential family members, you reduce the marketing cost by 20%.
Yeah. So simply, your and your brother and your father would have an order from a different mobile numbers, but the address would have been same. Yeah. So if someone wants to do a direct mailer campaign, mentioning over a postal letter and send you across, instead of sending three direct mailers to your home, we'll be sending only one. So in our database currently, using that matching that address algorithms, we figured out that there's a 20% set of customers who tend to order from a different mobile numbers, where simply the marketing cost got down by 20%.
I think you can take the question offline.
Yeah.
Thank you.